Since I'm a great fan of RPN calculators, I thought it would be a good idea to give a brief introduction to how to use RPN calculators. RPN is, of course, an acronym for reverse Polish notation. And RPN is a postfix notation, as opposed to the algebraic way of entering numbers, which is an infix notation. Infix means that you put the operator, that's for example the plus or minus sign, between the operands, the things that you want to add or subtract, like in this case, for example, 1 plus 3. While on an RPN calculator, you start by supplying the calculator with the operands, and then at the end, you give them the operator, what you want to do with the numbers. So let's look at this simple expression here, 8 divided by 1 plus 3. And we start by using an algebraic ordinary calculator. And obviously, we can't just enter the numbers like this, 8 divided by 1 plus 3 equals. Because then you get 11, because it will start by dividing 8 by 1 and then add 3. But what you would like to do here is to add these two first and then divide 8 by the sum of these. Then you would have to use either the memory function here, or you can use parentheses like 8 divided by parentheses 1 plus 3 end parentheses equals 2. This is good enough, but when you have large or complicated expressions with a lot of parts that are to be divided or subtracted or whatever from each other, then easily gets messy using the algebraic notation. And the good thing about it is that it looks a lot like things you would write on a paper, but the bad thing is that you will have usually to use a lot of parentheses, and you will often have to enter the entire expression at once. While the RPN notation, I think, is much more suited for the human brain, at least for my brain, because it supports the way you think about mathematics much better. So if you're not copying something from paper, but you are actually calculating things as you go along, then the RPN calculator, at least I think so, gives you much better support for calculations. And to calculate this thing in an RPN calculator, here we have something called Alcula. I just found it on the internet, but there are a lot of RPN calculators, physical as well. So to calculate this thing, you would simply start by entering 8. And as you can see, it ends up here in something called the stack. That's a powerful concept with several rows here. And it's much like the memory or memories of algebraic calculator. And it keeps track of several numbers at once. So you start by 8 and it ends up here in the lowest part. Then I press enter, and the 8 moves up here. It also remains here with an X here, but you can disregard that. So the second thing I do is I enter 1. And as you can see, you now have 8 in the second level of the stack and 1 here. Press enter, and it all moves upwards. I then enter 3. So now we have 8, 1, 3. And then I start by adding these two together, and since they are in the lowest part of the stack, I simply press the plus sign, adding them together. They give a sum of 4. And as you can see, the 8 moves downwards because the two lowest level of the stack are added together and ends up in as a single digit here in the lowest part, and then the third one moves down to the second. So now we have the 8 here, and we have the sum of these two here. And then I want to divide them, so I press the division key here and get the result 2. That's RPN. Here we have a more complicated expression, as you can see here. But it's not that difficult when you use an RPN calculator, as it would have been using, for example, this calculator. So I start by pressing 8, enter, 5, and then I want to subtract these, so I press the minus key here. The result is 3. Then I want to raise them to the power of 2. I enter 2, power, and I get 9. 9 is this entire part of the expression. Then I move along to this part without, simply leave this here. So I enter 4. As you can see, the 9 moves upwards. 4, enter, 2, power. That's 4 to the power of 2. And then I enter 2. Now we have 16, this part. We have 2 here. And I want to subtract them, so I press the minus sign. 14, that's this part. And now I want the square root of this. I press the square root key here. So we have 9, this part. We have 3.74, this part. And I want to multiply them. So I simply press the multiplication key here. Then I move along to this part, 3, enter, 6, and plus, because I want to add these two. The result is 9. So now I have the result of this part here, the second level of the stack, and I have the sum of these two at the first level of the stack, and then I finally want to divide them by pressing the division key. And the result of the entire expression is 3.74 roughly. That's it.